exalt his name. Can we just magnify his great name? Have your way, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's a sweet spirit of the Lord in this place. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship your holy name. We adore you, mighty God. We kneel down before you. We worship your holy name. Yashando kataro. Hallelujah. Mighty God, we say thank you, Jesus. We worship your holy name. Lord, we adore you. Mighty God, we kneel down before you. See, we worship your holy name. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship your holy name. We worship your Jesus.
We worship your holy name.
Mighty God, we adore you.
We adore you.
This is not a joke thing tonight.
We kneel down before you.
We worship your name.
We worship your name.
We worship your name.
Worship your name.
Worship your name.
Worship your name.
Worship your name. everybody stand to their feet? Can everybody stand to their feet? Can we just worship? As the choral humming, can we just worship? Can we adore him? Mighty God, my Savior, my Redeemer. Ah, hallelujah. Powerful Jesus, Sovereign King. Echo Shata Darama.
Honor to you for your love.
Hallelujah.
We want to thank you for your grace.
I will sing.
We worship you tonight. Give you thanks, I gotta give
all
you
all honor.
Saints of God, I'm scared. I'm scared that somebody's gonna walk out of the presence of God. In a service like this, I'm going to remain the same. Saints of God, can you feel a burning for somebody beside you who is unsaved? Somebody beside you who is struggling, who is coming out of 2015 with a rough patch, and willing to go into 2016 the same way. I'm scared that they're going to walk out and not allow the Spirit of God to change the situation, to change their hearts. Saints of God, can you help me to pray for them now? I don't want anybody to leave the same way they came. If you are here and during 2015 you did some stuff that you didn't want to do, some stuff you weren't proud of, if you're here under the sounding of my voice, you hurt some people you may not have wanted to hurt. You shoot somebody you didn't necessarily want to. You stab somebody you never wanted to. You got somebody pregnant and you never really intended to. You got pregnant and that was not your intention. You started divorce proceedings and that was not your intention. You had an abortion and that was not your intention. If you're here and anything happened to you that you never really planned for and you see it as something bad, let me tell you, it's in the past. The Spirit of God can touch you. The Spirit of God is touching you. Even now, will you hear the voice of God and answer? Don't walk out into 2016 the same way you came. The Spirit of God has borne witness. This church believes in allowing the Spirit of God to take preeminence in everything. We don't have a set program. If the Spirit of God says stop, change the song, then the Spirit of God will do it to save your soul. If you're on the internet listening, don't turn it off the same way you came. You're just walking in. The Spirit of God is speaking to your heart. Don't harden your heart. If you are supposed to be saved and you know you're not living right, get right. Put it in the past and just move on. Just get up, brush yourself off. Move on. Step into the righteousness of God and see God transform your life again. Can we worship God? This is no ordinary service. The Spirit of God resides here. He does as He pleases. Let's lift up our hands and worship before the choir come. Come on. We can afford sometime to worship God. He's kept us through 2015. So many persons' eyes were closed and they never made it this far. But here I am. Here I am. But by the grace of God. But by the grace of God. Don't walk out the same way you came in. Don't sign out the same way you came in. Don't log off the stream the same way you came in. A living dog is better than a dead lion.
The lifestyle may not have been right in 2015, but God can fix it for this year. Situation may not have been perfect, but God can fix you in the situation. Hallelujah. Choir, come and minister as God has led you. Brother Carlson, hallelujah. And the Faith Chapel Choir, in Jesus' name.
Can we just continue to exalt him? Can we just continue to exalt the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? The conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. Heaven is so big and it cannot contain you, Jesus. But you dwell in my heart. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. No amount of problems or cares can come against the fact that I love you, Jesus. Can we just adore him? Can we just exalt him? That is all God wants of us tonight, is true worship. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, salvation and glory, honor and power unto the Lord, our God. For the Lord, our God, he's mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, he is wonderful. Can I sing it just one more time? Hallelujah. I give myself salvation and glory, honor and power unto the Lord, our God. For the Lord our God, he is mighty. Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent. The Lord our God, he is wonderful.
Yeah. Can we stand to our feet, everybody? Lift your hands and begin to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the great conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. He is worthy to be praised. There's none like unto you. Hallelujah. There's none to be compared to you. From the rising of the sun, hallelujah, even to the going down of the very same. Hallelujah. 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 He's wonderful. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. We'll just close your eyes one more time. Let's begin to think about the King of Kings. Hallelujah. The Lord of Lords. The Lamb that sits on the throne. Hakuri Andaba. The King of Israel. The God of Gods. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask everybody, if you're in the sanctuary tonight, if you could just stand. Just stand. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. It's about time for us to receive a word from God. Amen. Praise God. The Bible says, heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will not pass away. It's time for us to receive a rhema word from God, a word from the throne. Amen. And if right now I'm going to ask our pastor to come, Pastor Daly, and he's going to come and to speak a word from God in Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on, we praise the Lord, everybody. Can we praise the Lord, everybody? Can I ask everyone in the house to put your hands together? Glorify the Lord. Here is what is going to happen. For just a few minutes, I really feel that there is a word for the saints of the assembly, and I want to take a few minutes to charge us and to exhort us and to give us that word. I'm going to step down afterwards, and then the choir will sing again. And I also have a small word for the unsaved in our midst. Amen. So I'm going to speak, and I'm going to come down, and I'm going to come back. Hallelujah, because there are some visitors here that we actually have arrested you already in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You cannot leave tonight to go to the Pegasus. You're going to have a ball in the house, and we arrest you. The Holy Ghost arrests you. And so we go, I'm going to talk to the saints for a minute or two, saints of God, and then I will be back. But let me ask, I'm not even sure, you know this little one, it says, you may feel down and feel like God. Oh, hallelujah. I'm talking about some saint in the house right now has somehow forgotten. Oh, hallelujah. Can I encourage the heart of the saints in the house? He has not forgotten. In fact, he asked me to tell you tonight that he is still able. That's the word. He is still able. What is he still able to do? Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. He is still able to deliver. Oh, hallelujah. He is still able to bring us through. Oh, hallelujah. He is still able to lift you up, make you strong. Hallelujah. Bear you up on eagle's wings. He wants me to remind you that he is still able. But I feel to ask some singer to sing that song. You may feel down and think that God have somehow forgotten. I greet you, Sister Ruby, in Jesus' name. Greet Bishop Edwards. Greet Pastor Tucker. I greet you. I greet you, my dear sister, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, sing.
You may feel down and feel like God has somehow forgotten that you are faced,
hallelujah,
with circumstances that you can't get through. Right now it seems that there's no way out and you're going under.
You're not going under. Hallelujah.
But God's proven time and time again that he'll take care of you. God has somehow forgotten that you are faced with circumstances that you can't get through. Oh, right now it seems that there's no way out and you're going under. But God's proven time and time again.
Oh, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Praise God. Praise God, praise God. Praise God. First, Second Chronicles, I read. And you can follow as I read. Second Chronicles, chapter 32. Let me read verse 7. I'll start with verse 7. Be strong and courageous. Be not afraid nor dismayed, for the king of Assyria, nor for all the multitude that is with him. For there be more with us than with him. With him is an arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. Hallelujah. And the people rested themselves upon the words of Hezekiah, king of Judah. But I read a little further. Hear this, saints. After this, apparently Sennacherib heard the words. It was conveyed back to him that they were speaking a decision. He had to decide if he was going to serve the Lord or if he was going to bow down and follow the dictates of Assyria, although they were a superpower. And he looked at the whole scenario and he made a decision. We are called upon today, saints of the Most High God, to make a decision to live righteously. We are called upon today, saints of the Most High God, to decide if we are going to serve God or if we are going to walk according to the dictates of men. Oh, can we praise the Lord? What we are going through today is nothing new. We recognize that a few months ago, some folks were here that told us that we must love everybody. And that is Bible. We must love our neighbors. We must love our enemy. If our enemy, in fact, the Bible says, feed your enemy. So when they say love everybody, they were not off key. We must love. But we must understand when God talks about love, what he's talking about. Can we praise the Lord? We must understand when Jesus said we must love, we must know what he's talking about. He wants us to love each other with brotherly love. He wants us to love each other with the love of God. He wants us to love each other as fellow human beings. He wants us to love each other as a part of the common human race. And we must have sympathy and empathy and love and show regard one for the other. But there are some things that the Bible, that Almighty God through his word told us that we must abstain from, that we must stay far from, that we must not get involved in, that we must not do. God told us to walk a certain way, to walk along a certain path. And if you name the name of Jesus, we must walk with him. We must talk with him. We must live with him and for him. It does not matter what the kings of Assyria says. What is important is what the word of God says. Can we praise the Lord? And Hezekiah decided that he was going to follow the Lord. Hezekiah decided that comes what may. And what may did come. Because he got up and he said, we're not going to bow to the king of Assyria. We're not going to pay homage to the king of Assyria. We are going to pay homage to God. He is our savior. He is our healer. He is our deliverer. He is the one that opened the Red Sea and caused us to come across and brought us into the land of Canaan. He is the one that we are going to bow before and not another. And when the king of Assyria heard, he said, what is happening to those people? They are moving away from under the influence of Assyria. But how can they do that? We are the superpower. But little did Sennacherib knew that he was no superpower. The superpower was in heaven itself. The superpower was Almighty God himself. And Hezekiah pulled back and said, we will not bow to you. And so they came down and encamped around Judah and decided that they were going to take them as hostage. They were going to take them as servants and let them serve them. But when they came and when they decided that they were going to go in and take over Judah, the people of God did something. The people of God called on somebody. The people of God leaned on a shoulder. The people of God cried out from the bottom of their heart. The people of God prayed to the God of heaven. The people of God looked to the hills from whence cometh their help. The people of God remembered that their help cometh from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. And if he made the heavens and the earth, if he made it all, it means that he was the mighty God. And if they are looking to the hills from whence cometh their help, and their help comes from the mighty God, then it was the mighty God that they were calling on. There is something that every saint of God must know tonight, that when you call on him with a true heart, he's bound by his word to come to your assistance. He wants you to know that if he doesn't come today, he's going to come tomorrow. And if he doesn't come tomorrow, he's going to come next week. And if he doesn't come next week, he's going to come on time. But he is going to show up. He's bound by his words to show up. You might say, I almost fell in 2015. Oh, that's almost. You didn't fall. That's almost. What held you by a thread was the mercies of Almighty God. You might not know it, but when you thought that you were gone and now you're in church on the verge of 2016, it was the mercies of God. You thought it was buck up. But in the house of God, there is no such thing as buck up. There is no such thing as chance. God was there. Jesus was there. When you thought you were going to fall and you're not sure what happened, and you say, thank you, brother, for praying for me. Nothing is wrong with that. When while the brother's prayer helped, it wasn't the brother that really kept you. It was him. Somebody praise the Lord. When you got laid off from the job and you thought that nothing was going to happen, you thought you tried everything, you sent out so many applications and nothing was happening, and you said, God, why me? And then you went on prayer and fasting and you call on the name of the Lord, and nothing happened today and nothing happened the other day, but one day it happened and the job came. One day it happened and the job came. It wasn't chance. It wasn't contacts. I was trying a thing and it never worked. Contacts don't work when it come on to the things of God. Contact will forget you. Contact will leave you. Contacts will tell you, say, I'm doing it for you. And when it come up, give it to somebody else. That is what earthly contacts do. But when you cry to God, when you say, Jesus, I am at my wit's end, help. Then he that neither slumbers nor sleep, he that is awake in the midnight hour, when you're crying, is going to hear you. And he's bound to come to you. He is going to show up. He's going to show up. And so Hezekiah and Isaiah cried to God. And they camped around Judah for a while. And the king of Assyria, the superpower, had them locked in for a while until the water was running out and things were happening. Why God? Why God you make it have to happen? That the water run out and the place get dry. Why God you make us have to go into the lion's den and you don't turn up? Why God you make us have to be in the fiery furnace and you don't turn up? Why God you cause us to have to go through these things and you just don't turn up? But notice that although you go through the furnace, you're not going to be burned. Notice that although you're in the lion's den, not a lion can open his mouth and bite you. We need to understand how God works. Amen. You need to understand how God does his thing. God is not going to keep you from lions in the sense that you're not going in the den. But if God wants you to do a thing and God has a plan for you, which he has, he's going to allow you to go into the den. He's going to cause you to smell the lion. He's going to cause you to tremble a little bit. He's going to cause your heart to flutter, flutter, flutter. He's going to cause you to call upon him. He's going to make the lion brush you with his tail. But then, no, no, no. Although his tail brush you, although you smell his breath, although his whiskers come by your foot, him can't open his mouth because God hold it there. Don't worry when you're in the lion's den. Lift up your voice and praise God. He knows how to shut lion mouth. He knows how to make them belly full. Those lions were hungry. But a praying man was walking through, and a praying man and a worshiping man. When we worship and praise God, when we lift him up and we pray, it doesn't matter how close the lion come and walk. I believe the lion might even have lift up his back foot like they normally do, and wee against the thing because he had his prey covered. Lion tail. We don't, and it's true, God will send our junkra to feed you. Don't watch God enough. God do some serious thing. When God ready to take care of his children, him send junkra, him turn up furnace, him make lion come round you, him make bear come round you, him do all kind of thing. But one thing I never say God unable to stop the lion. I never see him unable to make you walk through the fire and not be burnt. He's able to do that. He's able to do that. And so the men of Assyria, the mighty men of valor, and the captains and the great men stood around ready to fight. And when the men of God prayed, when the people cried out, God said, angel over there, come here. Look over there. You see that? Hear the sound. Tell, what is that that I hear? It is the sound and the cry of prayer. It is the sound of people worshiping. It is the sound of people lifting up Jesus. Even though they are in their lion's den. You in lion's den? Anybody here know about lion den? You know about fiery furnace? Keep the mouth closed. And even if you turn up the fire 7 times hotter, you ever been in fire and it turn up? I know some folks are here and your fire turn up. You're going through some things in your family. Fire turn up. You're going through some things in your home. Fire turn up. You thought it couldn't happen and now it has been at a point where you think it's going to be all over. Fire turn up. And all kind of things are happening. The fire turn up. You're on your job and you're here next year. I hear a thing. Say, whole heap of people might get redundant from public sector. Fire turn up. Some folks who they plan to buy them house and all kind of thing, put the plans down. Fire turn up. But let me tell the saints of the Most High God, when Hezekiah and Isaiah cry to God, God sent an angel. And when God called him, I said, go down there. He said, where? He said, listen to the sound that you hear coming up. Follow the sound. And he followed the sound. And it went right down to where Hezekiah and Isaiah was. And the angel went into the camp of the Assyrians and walking with his sword. And the Bible said he smote. Hallelujah. Him kill. He passed through one angel. God never even called a legion. Legion! One, him said, you. And if it's Michael, you know, he would have called him name because Michael, you know, ordinary angel. When Michael come in, God says, Michael, himself defend the body of Moses. So this angel was nameless. He probably take him from the back room and say, come here. I'm going to give you an errand. Go down and deal with Assyria. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care, saints of the Most High God, what nobody say. Cry out to God. Lift your feet. Worship him. Job or no job. And when he heard the cry of his people and he sent the angel, all the captain of the host and the mighty men of valor and the great men were dead. So that when Sennacherib heard him grab him thing and run go back to him, Sennacherib the king, run shame like dog, tail between his legs, and go back where him come from. And the Lord directed me to tell some saint in the house, he is still able. Oh, hallelujah. The Lord directed me to tell some saint, he is still able. You may not know how. You may not know when. You may not know exactly what he's going to do. But he's going to come. He's going to turn up. I close, saints of the Most High God, because I have delivered the word. There's a modern day Assyria, both in the physical realm and in the spiritual realm. And the modern day Assyria is pressuring the people of God. There is going to come a time when this church is going to be pressured, where you have marriage license certificates and they are going to tell you that you have to marry men, and we are going to have to make a decision. Is either we obey God or we obey man. Nobody can tell you, if you're a marriage officer, that you must marry a man and a man, or a woman and a woman. The laws of Assyria, just like it was then, is rampant in the environment of the world today. And so the superpowers are going around the world pressuring folks to change the laws to accommodate a lifestyle which is opposed to the word of God. But I have to say to the saints of God, you have to decide who you're going to serve. Some church have gay bishops now. They are bishop but they're gay. Some church have gay apostle such and such, praying and speaking in tongues, but they are homosexuals. We're not hating anybody. We're not saying that you are this or you're that. Sinner like anybody else. But you don't come to the house and say that in the house you must conform to this. If it is opposed to the Bible, it cannot be conformed to. We walk by the word. We live in the word. We stand upon the word. Oh, can we praise the Lord? And we are going to be pressured. We are going to come under serious pressure. But I feel like telling the saints of the Most High God, make up your mind. Is either God or man. And God the Almighty has indicated what he did then for Hezekiah is the same God. Hallelujah. And he's in the house right now. And he runs Jamaica. And he runs America. Irrespective of what the men are doing, there is a God that rules in the kingdom of men. And this God is whom we trust. And when it comes time to defend, you see, when we preach the word and we teach the word and we stand upon the word, there's going to come a time when we are going to be attacked. But guess who is going to defend us? Guess who we have as our defender? And my God is a man of war. He can fight, you see. He never lose a battle. Him give the knockout punch. Him know when to back. And when you think he's finished, he's finished. When you think you have him, them nail him on the tree and think them have him. And them don't know, say, it's a strategy. It's so him was going all along, you know. It's so him was going all along. And when them nail him to the tree, and they thought he was dead, and they thought they had him now, finally I get rid of him, it's so him was going. And it's when he nail go in him hand, you see, when the nail went in his feet, he was still going, so. And when he said, it is finished, and Satan said, yes, I have him now. My God, him go down to hell, you see? And hell and powder house. He was going so hard along. And when he reached down there, whoop, Satan get a right. And in hell, he preached down there and led captivity captive. Bring them back out. Tear them from the clutches of the enemy. When they thought him can fight him, just full of strategy and wisdom. And he's on our side, saints of the Most High God. You can't lose. The fight is fixed. Pastor King, it fix any move you make. He makes a move, but him always, I can't tell you much about chess, but him always in the most strategic position. Never lose a battle. Can I tell the saints of the Most High God, he's still able. He's still able. He's still able. He is still able.
Can we lift up our hands, everybody? Come on, lift up your hands if you know he's able. Lift up your hands and worship him. Thank you, God. Right now, Brother Carlton will be coming again, and the Faith Chapel Choir will be ministering one more time before we get to the final part of the word. Don't move a muscle. Praise God.
How many people are grateful for mercy tonight? How many people are grateful for the blood tonight? Come on. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but if it hadn't been for God, if it hadn't been for mercy, if it hadn't been for grace, I wouldn't be here tonight. Come on, worship with us. Hallelujah. Thank God for your mercy. It was your mercy and your grace. Hallelujah. Years I spent.
Vanity,
Ephraim.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. 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 You're here because you want 2016 to catch you in an environment of praise and worship. You believe that if you're caught in church at the clock striking midnight going beyond, good luck will follow you. You believe that if you're here and start the year like this, blessings will follow you throughout the year and everything is going to be all right. But history would have indicated to you that it doesn't work like that. Because many who are here tonight, you were here last year, the year before, the year before. And although it's good for you to come into the house, and we are happy that you're here, it is going to take more than a watch night service for you to have a good year. It is going to take a real, live, hot, personal relationship with Almighty God for things to be good for you tomorrow and next week and next month. Oh, can we praise the Lord? Can we praise the Lord? You might not know, but there is a major shift in the atmosphere. There is a whole lot of demonic workings, activities in the atmosphere right now. It's different than it was last year or a few years ago. We are finding that it is increasingly difficult, and you're finding that as an unsaved person, you are tormented day and night. You look good as you sit here. Physically, you are very attractive. Some of you laugh and smile a lot, and you're the life of the party, and everything is going good, it would seem. But nobody knows when you leave the party and the lights are switched off and you close the door and the friends are gone and the laughter is finished, and you look in the mirror and you see yourself and you feel empty and dry and tormented and discouraged and disappointed. You feel suicidal. Why? Because you just committed an abortion and it's eating you out. You feel that you are going to die the next moment because everything that can go wrong is going wrong for you. The Bible tells us of a man. His name was Naaman. Let me tell you about Naaman. There in 2 Kings chapter 5 and verse 1, it said, "Now Naaman, captain of the host of the king of Syria, was a great man with his master and honorable, because by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He was also a mighty man of valor." He was well known, well recognized. He was known in the gates. When people saw Naaman, they bowed to him. When people saw Naaman, they saluted him. When people saw Naaman, they esteemed him highly. A society man,
the right hand of the king. Like many people who are here tonight, you're just here because you want a blessing. It's watch night service. You're just here because you want to ring in the new year, being in the presence of God, being in church. But you're not here. You might not know it, but you're not here by chance. You might have come to start the year right, but it was Almighty God that pulled you in the house tonight. And He wants you to know that you have a purpose. There is a reason for your living. You are not another number in the 7 billion that is here. You are special. You are unique. You have a function. And He knows your name. He knows your number. He knows everything about you. He knows what you did the other day. He knows that you have committed 1, 2, 3 abortions and you're being eaten out right now. You're here because you want help. You're here. Oh, hallelujah. Because you are desperate. You're not here because you want to ring in the ear, right? You're here because you want help. You want deliverance. But you're in the right place because the God that delivers men is in the house right now. You're on the verge of suicide. You decided that you were going to take your life the other day, and it didn't happen. Nobody seemed to care. You have not eaten for how long? You have not worked a job. You have not done anything to get an income for how long? And you feel that you are all alone. Your family thinks you're worthless. They think you are no good. You are nobody. But you are in a place where the Most High God, the God that created the heavens and the earth, hallelujah, the God that made you, He's saying you are special. Hallelujah. Even though you committed those acts, you are special. Even though you have the gun and you're getting ready to pull the trigger, and you have come into this place one more time because you swear, so you're going to get that guy because of what he did, I arrest you in Jesus' name. Masandabaya. I arrest you. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost said tonight is your night. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Put down that rope. Put down that rope. Put down that bottle with the pills that you are planning to take. The deliverer is calling your name. I know your name, He said. Although you have not known me, I know you. I know you. And I have ordained you. Hallelujah. You might be unsaved. No. You might be unsaved tonight. Who tell Pastor about what I did? Nobody. I don't know you. I don't know anything about you. I don't know where you live. I don't know your neighbors. I don't know nothing. But I do know that the God of heaven has a plan for you. And Naaman, although everybody looked up to him and he was a mighty man and he was well respected, and when he walked out, pomp and pageantry and all kind of things. But Naaman, when he reached home and he put down his sword and he put down his shield and he took off his soldier's hat, the Bible said, but he was a leper. Oh, hallelujah. Everybody saluting him. Everybody elevating him. But when he reached home,
and he looked in the mirror. When the trumpeters put down their trumpets, when those that cried before him and shouted before him as captain of the host stopped shouting, when he went inside and closed the door, he was a leper. Was not fit to be walking among the other members of society. Probably because of his status, the king allowed him, wrap him up in soldier clothes, hiding his leprosy, but he was a leper. Known in the camp, but a leper. Known by everybody, but a leper. Naaman, the mighty man of valor, looked in the mirror and cried every day, Lord, why me? I have to hide from everybody. Look how mighty I am. Look how handsome and big and powerful I am. And I am just a leper. But thank God that there was somebody in Naaman's house who could tell him that there is a God over there in Israel and a prophet of the king, that if you call upon him, he can take away the leprosy. There are some Naamans in the house tonight. Oh, hallelujah. There are some Naamans in the house tonight, looking good. But when you go home, and even right here, leprosy. Leprosy. Unclean. Unclean. Sin has dominion over your mortal body. There are some Naamans in here right now, diseased because you have been in sin for so long. You are so contaminated. Many have been diagnosed with some things. You're here tonight and you're wondering. You heard that there is a house of deliverance down the road and you're here. You heard that you can get deliverance. Somebody told you that there is a God down there. That if you dare to try that God, we have seen him delivered. We have seen him set men free. We have heard the great things that he has done. And Naaman is in the house right now. Oh, hallelujah. And that damsel went down and declared that there is a God in Israel. Won't you go down and talk to the prophet? And he went down and spoke to the prophet. And the prophet said, come and go down in Jordan's water. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. There are some people right now. I thank God that you're here. Thank God that you came, even if it is to ring in the new year in church. But like we said, we arrest you tonight. There will be no Pegasus. Don't go. There will be no Quartzly. Don't go. There will be no all white affair at the arena or wherever. Don't go. You are in the house of deliverance. What you need is not over there. It is here tonight. And I ask for that song that was just sung to be raised as I call Naaman right now. Naaman. Naaman. Leprosy. Only you alone know about it. You alone know what is happening. You alone, when you go home and close the door, stand inside, you alone know how lonely you are, how empty you are, how dry you are, how parched you are. You alone know. And God. But the God of heaven, the Almighty, is in the house right now. Oh, hallelujah. The God of heaven is calling you by name. Oh, hallelujah. And he said, leave where you are and come.
I know how to remove leprosy from people's life and make them whole again. I know, says the Almighty. And he wants to prove himself to you. Hallelujah. We are happy that you came. And we love you tonight. And God loves you with an everlasting love. God loves you with a love that you cannot comprehend and will never fathom. And the altars are open right now. I'm going to ask the ushers and the people at the front to make a little way, because we want to make room for somebody, for some Naaman who needs deliverance, who needs to be set free. Hallelujah. We want to make room for you. We want to make room for you. We want to make room for you. Oh, sing that song. I am going to ask you right now, those that are in the house, thank God for those who are coming. You need Jesus. You want to give him a try, a chance. Come, come. I'm going to ask altar workers right now, make yourselves ready. Let's do this quickly, ushers, as quickly as we can. Bring the chairs back. Folks that are sitting in the chairs, just allow us to push it back. We'll get you another seat. We want to make room at the altars. God bless those who are here. Let me ask everybody to stand at this time. A defining moment. This is not about just being in church for 2016. This is about being in church so that the Almighty can minister healing to you, minister healing to your life. I'm going to ask you to grab a mic, grab the mic. Let's come, singers, come around. We're gonna sing this song. Amen. We're gonna sing this song. God bless those who are here. You know why you are here. Altar workers, this is not the designated group. This is every saint that can pray. Find somebody tonight. God bless those who are coming. Come on. Come on. Come right up. Don't stop in the aisles. We have space at the front. Come on. Just cry excuse and come around. Saints, make way. Look around. Just make way and have them to come around. Singers. Altar workers, come. Come. Come, young men. Come, leaders. Come, ministers. Come, prayer warriors. For folks are coming. Come. Yes. Let's cry excuse and come. There is room at the altar for you. Don't stop in the middle. We want to pray for you. We want to pray with you. Cry excuse and come. This is about you. This is about you making it right with God. This is about God ministering to you and removing what needs to be removed. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Come on, yes, come on. Come on. Later on, we are going to be praying for you. But we want some prayer warriors to lay hands and to pray for you. Can I ask some more of our saints to come, pray, minister. Sing the verse.
Someone here, and as the minister preached, you know that he was speaking to you, speaking to your heart, speaking to your situation. We invite you to come. The fact that you are here in these last moments of 2015, it means that God has kept you alive. This opportunity you may never have again. And so I encourage somebody right now to surrender to God. Surrendering your life to God is not a big thing. You don't need months of classes. You just need, in your mind, you just need to recognize that there has to be a change in your life. And if you are sick and tired tonight, sick and tired of the abuse, sick and tired of being unhappy, sick and tired of your situation, hallelujah, and you want a change in your life, that's all you need to come to God. It's called repentance. You want to change. You want to live how God wants you to live. Hallelujah. You don't have to know how it will be done. You just, once you need a change, I invite you to come. And the Bible says that if you want that change and you are willing to admit that you have done wrong things, you have sinned, but you want your life to turn around, that's called repentance. The Bible says that if you repent and you are baptized in water in the name of Jesus Christ, God will remove all of your sins. He will wipe the slate clean. Hallelujah. But better than that, if you are willing to come tonight and to surrender, to pray, God will fill you with His Spirit. And when you get the Spirit of God, you will be a new creature. You will have new desires. Hallelujah. All things will be passed away, the old things, and all things will become new. And so one last time, I invite you to come. Those who are at the altar, begin to pray. Begin to pray. Just close your eyes and begin to talk to God. Begin to ask Him to forgive you of your sins. Tell Him that you want to change. Once you have repented, you just need to worship. You might be here in a church and you don't know how to worship. You can simply just call upon the name of Jesus. That's all you need to do. If somebody would just pray now and begin to call upon the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Mercy is great in this place. God's grace is free. You don't have to pay thousands of dollars tonight. Hallelujah. You can get salvation purchased by the blood of God. Hallelujah. Begin to pray right now. Hallelujah. Everywhere you are. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your love. God, there are so many people, oh God, who I interacted with at the start of 2015. And oh God, I've been to their funerals. But oh God, everyone who is here in the house today, they are here because you have a purpose for their lives. Lord Jesus, if someone would recognize tonight that this is their last opportunity to get it right, if someone could recognize tonight that their lives might not be the way they want it to be, and their situation might not be the way that they want it to be, but God, you are able. God, you have all things under control. And so God, I pray, Lord God, transform lives tonight. Transform hearts tonight. Remove the hearts of stone and place within them hearts of flesh. God, I pray that your Holy Ghost and fire, Lord God, will fall upon every individual in this place. Lord God, those who came probably out of tradition, Lord God, I pray that deep conviction, Lord God, will arrest their hearts. Lord God, I pray that somebody will cry out unto you, Lord Jesus, and be broken, Lord God. Jesus, have mercy tonight, as we stare in the face of 2016, so many uncertainties. But oh God, if you are in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. Lord God, save someone tonight. Save men, save women, save children. Fill with your Holy Ghost. Let your power fall in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for salvation, we pray for healing. Oh God, we pray for deliverance. Lord God, you see that woman who's afraid. Hallelujah, she's afraid because if she gives her life to you, she will have no means of income. Lord God, but I pray that someone will step out, Lord God, tonight in faith. Lord God, trust in you. Hallelujah. Because you are able. Because you are able. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, come on. Begin to worship him and receive the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Worship God. Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. I see some people talking.